Channel Grandma is back. Grandma is fully back. You are also welcome to my kitchen. Let me remind you, if you have not subscribed, please, if today is your very first day of stopping by in my channel, you are highly welcome. And please don't go away without subscribing. Also turn on post notification so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. Grandma is fully back. I am back. So, I am going to take you along as usual. So, today, my chicken are eating. So, I'm sure you can hear them. So, please, don't mind them. Today, Grandma is going to show you how to prepare brasa soup. Brasa soup. Hey, hear them. Have you ever heard of such name? Brasa soup is a very special soup that can be eaten anytime, anyhow, anywhere. Brasa soup can be eaten with eba, it can be eaten with fufu, it can be eaten with wheat. You can eat it just as you like. So, before we start cooking, before the cooking proper, I am going to show you all the necessary ingredients that you need to prepare this special and tasty brasa soup. So, let me show you all the ingredients. The first ingredient you need is bitter leaf. So this is bitter leaf. I have taken time to wash this bitter leaf myself, and so it is very, very clean and good to go. You also need water leaf, a very fresh water leaf, well washed and cut. Here I have melon. In my language, we call it ikun. So this is what is going to make this soup to be brasas. You also need stockfish. If you don't have stockfish, you can do without it. I equally have dried chicken. I have seasoned this chicken properly. Steam and then dry it with an oven. I also have dry meat. This is dry smoked fish. You equally need palm oil, crayfish, dry pepper, and also salt to taste. For seasoning, I have Maggi seasoning and also chopped onions. So the next thing we need to do is to move down to the stove and start cooking. I'm going to start by adding the stockfish, also the dry meat, and the chicken. I'm going to add 1 cup of water, and then add the seasonings. I'm going to add salt and then adjust it a little and allow it to balance well in the pot. I'm going to cover it and allow it to cool for 30 minutes before adding water for the soup proper. I'm going to add 1 cup of water. I'm going to add pepper. Please add the pepper based on your choice. Also crayfish. You need plenty of crayfish, so you really have to add plenty. I'm going to add the fish. And then stir it and allow it to mix properly. I'm going to cover it and allow it to cook for just 1 minute before adding palm oil. After 1 minute, I'm going to add palm oil. You need to add plenty of palm oil because this soup needs plenty of palm oil. I'm going to cover it and allow it to cook for additional 1 minute before adding the mamoikon, efere ticha, mamoikon, efere ticha, mamoikon, efere ticha.
I have to stir it and stir it gently and then taste for salt. Oh my God. So, so delicious. I'm going to add the water leaf first. Adjust it gently so that, my fish will not scatter. I know that no matter how you care for a fish in the pot, it must scatter. I'm going to cover it for additional 1 minute before adding the antidote, that is bitter leaf. Remember, we are preparing brasa soup. Yes, it's exactly 1 minute. So I'm going to add bitter leaf. This is the bitter leaf that I wash. I wash this bitter leaf myself. And I have a video on how to wash bitter leaf to this extent. So you can check that out. Once you have added the bitter leaf, you have to stir it. Stir it properly and allow it to mix before adding the ikun or melon. This is melon. In my language, we call it ikun. This is what makes it brassas. You don't need to fry this ikun or melon. This is how we add it, and that is what makes it brassas. You see that the soup is very dry. You can either add water or add palm oil. So in my own case, I'm going to add palm oil. I don't want to add water because I don't want it to be very watery. So I'm going to cover it and allow it to cook for 2 minutes until everything marinates together, and then I will put it down and serve. Wow! I'm sure you can see the face of the soup. Oh my God. Please don't fail to prepare this brassas at home for your family. I'm sure you have seen how I prepared this brassas soup. This soup can be eaten with fufu, it can be eaten with garri, it can be eaten with wheat. Please don't fail to prepare this soup at home for your family. Today's post notification shout out goes to a post notification shout out, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Turn on post notification when you subscribe so that you'll be notified on time. Also, be the first to comment and get a shout out in my next video. See you in my next video. Bye.